guys, it's Amy from Now Polish Baby 90 and welcome to today's video. Today I'm here with Empties. I'm trying to do what I did last time, where I'm going to do it more often and they're going to be shorter videos rather than letting the Empties build up for so long that the videos are half an hour long. So I think that's probably how you guys would like it too. So we're going to do Empties. The bag doesn't even look full, but I've got a ton of smaller products in here this time. So let's dive in. First of all, I said in one of my other videos that I wanted to start telling you guys what Lush products I use, because I feel that I haul them in videos but I never really show the actual products. So I wrote down actually on the bag as well. So I used an experimental bath bomb this month, and that is one of those ones that everybody loves. It's one of the ones that's 100 different colours in one, and it is amazing for bath art. I think I've got one on my like personal Instagram, a picture of the bath art that I created. You put it in, all these amazing blues, yellows, pinks, all kind of like this beautiful pattern. But as soon as you dump yourself in, it goes to a horrible murky grey colour. And I don't know, I find it like I'm washing in dirty water. So I don't know. I don't think I'm a hugest fan of it. I don't think I would ever choose to buy it now. I had two in the gift sets that I bought at Christmas, so I think I've experimented out. It's got a really nice smell to it. It's really vanilla-y. So again, that's not my total personal preference. I do tend to like non-foodie scents more, but it's not for everybody, but most people seem to like the experimenter. The other product I used up from Lush in the bath scents is I used up the Milky Bar Bubble Bar, which looked like a little milk bottle with a silver cap on the top, not tap. I did really like this one. It didn't really make much a difference to the colour of your bath, but it was really, really nice and like hydrating. I think if I can still read it over here, it's got a little bit of orange oil in here, and it's meant to smell and be like milk, and it does look like you're bathing in milk. It does make a nice amount of bubbles. It was quite nice and hydrating, but not too oily. So overall, I did really like the Milky Bath, and I wouldn't be opposed to having another one. And I used up a Bubble Off product this month, and I will link Bubble Off down below for you. And I used up the Wawa, I believe it was in the sandalwood scent. Really, really like the scent. I do love them. If you don't know what a Wawa is, it's a deep conditioning bath bomb. It does foam up a little bit, but it doesn't make bubbles. And it's just really, really hydrating for your skin. I really liked it. I liked all the other ones. The only thing that I noticed with the sandalwood one opposed to other ones I've used is I did leave a coloration around my bath when I got out. So not a problem. Just be aware that if you don't like products that make your bath like a little bit dirty, that you're gonna have to rinse it off again after you bath, that one might not be the one for you. But smell payoff, skin felt great, all the good things that come with the Bubble Off Wawas. Things I can see, the next product right here is another Lush one. Let's talk about it. Snow Fairy. I bought this Snow Fairy shower gel on sale at Christmas time. People go crazy for this. Let me see, can you see this little tiny bit left? People go absolutely crazy for this. It's their bubblegum scented shower gel. It does smell like bubble gums. Some people find it really sickly. I find it's okay in small quantities. I don't think I would ever be someone that would buy vats and vats and vats of it and would only shower in that. I liked it for a little while. I don't like it for the whole of my life. So it's good. Get it at Christmas if you want to try it out. And I know that the younger generation really, really like it. I used some different skin facial wipes this month. I went for something different, and this is the Garnier Skin Naturals Simple Essentials Removing Off Waterproof Makeup. I've never tried this type of wipe from Garnier before. I found them really affordable, I found them really moisturising and wet, and I found them very, very good at taking off makeup. So some days if I had a light face on, I would just use this, and then I would go in with like a milk cleanser in the morning. Or if I would have a full face on, I would remove it with stuff with the cleansing oil and then go back in with these just to get the last little bits out. So overall, I really, really like those, and I probably would repurchase. I have a Body Milk by Carez, and I, although this doesn't really have any instructions on it, I took this as this Body Milk was like a moisturizer, but the moisturizer in this, I don't know, it was very, very milky. The first time I used it, I spilled way too much. A little of this goes a long way. I've had it for a long time. I don't think I'd ever repurchase it, because I really like moisturizing products that are really thick and absorbing quickly rather than thin ones. I used my favourite heat defence spray. This is the John Frieda heat defence. I've repurchased this many, many times. I find it's one of the heat defences that doesn't make my hair greasy. I find some of the other ones, obviously where they've got those sort of protecting properties in them, just make me feel greasy, so I would always repurchase that. I have multiple bags of the Tesco's Value Everyday Cotton Pads. I use those to take off makeup and nail polish. I have two lots of hairspray this month. The first one was absolutely rubbish, and this is the Pro Formula Firm Hold by Tesco. And it says it's got argan oil in it. I didn't really find it gave me any hold at all, really. And seeing as this is like their middle range, Tesco's have like a value range, a middle range, and then a finest range. The value one I find is much better than this one, so don't waste your money on the upgrade, just go for the Tesco cheapest. And then we have the Tresemme Salon Touchable Feel in Ultimate Hold. Really like this one, lasted a long time, and it should have done because it was in a massive can. If this was ever on sale, I think I would purchase this one. I really like the smell of Tresemme hairspray, so that might make me a weirdo, but I do really like the smell of them. I have a deodorant, and this is the Nivea Antiperspirant for Black and White. It's a deodorant, it smells quite nice, and I do like the fact that if you spray and then put black clothing on, it doesn't transfer. So if I ever pick up a Nivea one, I always pick up that one. I have a toothpaste. This is the Colgate Optic White. I've said in multiple videos, I'm always on anything that says that it's going to make my teeth whiter. I feel like this did make a difference. I preferred this one to the other whitening one that I used, maybe the last Empties, the one before that. I did prefer this one, definitely did prefer it. Did it make too much of a difference? I'm not convinced. I have a dry shampoo. This is the Batiste Dry Shampoo in Divine Dark. Multiple repeat. I've got a massive double size one of this now. I really, really like this one. If you have dark hair and you like dry shampoo, this is the one to go for. It gives a very, I know it looks very harsh maybe there, but it's a very slight hint of colour. So when you spray this on your hair, you're not left with white hair, you're just left with brown. So sometimes if you would spray this and then maybe run your hands through your hair straight away, a little bit of it would come off on your fingers, but it's not a lot. I think sometimes people are scared of the tinted ones, but don't be scared. They're amazing. I have one big candle this month, and this is the Everyday Luxe in Coastal Blossoms. Now, Everyday Luxe, according to the bottom, is an American brand. So if anybody's heard of this in America, let me know. I got this from TK Maxx. I've got another one that I'm burning at the moment. I really, really like them. They were the kind of three wick candles. The only thing is it did go down to quite a lot left than the bottom there, but the wicks, I tried to like dig them out. You just can't get anything more out of them. So I'm a little bit bummed about that, but I did overall love the scent. Did I say what the scent was? This is in Coastal Blossoms. Yeah, I really did like this one. It's just a little bit floral and a little bit of like sea salty ocean scent. So that's like my perfect mix. I think a few candles that I've shown have been kind of like coastal and floral. I don't know. Weird mix, but I like it. We're on to makeup items at the end now. And I should also say, I think what I'm going to do is if I have any nail polish empties, I'm going to be showing them in my monthly favourites. I'll do like monthly favourite nail polish empties at the end rather than do them in this video. I don't have any this month, I just thought I would tell you that. I have two makeup brushes, and these are by Barbara Daly, who did, I don't know if they do it anymore, but did have a range of makeup at Tesco's. These were really good when I first started makeup. This is the blush and all over face powder brush. I haven't used these in a really long time, and if you can see it, I don't know if it'll even focus. They are shedding really, really badly. They're not the most dense of brush, like look at the powder brush. They are good for a beginner or someone on a budget, but now I have more, like not being a snob, but now I have more expensive brushes that just do the job better. So they were good. I would obviously never repurchase, but I would recommend them to anybody just getting into makeup. I have two products from the balm. The first one is the Stainiac, and this was a miniature. Let me see if it will focus. I got this in Birchbox, and it's one of those lip and cheek stains. I did use this on my lips, and I did really like it. And I pulled this out the other day, and it's just, can you see, it's like separated and drying and goopy, and yeah, I'm not about that anymore. It did work really well. I never used it on my cheeks. I only ever used it on my lips, and I did really like it. That's my thoughts. The other thing, which is at the moment I was going through any Birchbox samples that I had left over, and I was depotting them into a Z palette that I bought, and I was going to put this in there, and this is the How About Those Apples. Can we focus on how cute this is? Focus, focus, focus. How About Those Apples, and then I got the one in Pie. So these are again lip and cheek stains. As you can see, my one is kind of, it's really, really dry and crumbly. I don't know if it will focus on that. And when I put my finger in there, I almost got, it almost all fell out on me. So I can't really have it anymore. I did at one time consider buying this palette in massive, just because I really like them for my lips. I found them really moisturising and hydrating, and I don't know, I really, really did like those. And the one in pie was on my lips at one point all the time until I obviously packed that away and forgot about it. A lip product. Empties. This is a lip balm and I have used it up. This is the Lip Smoochie by CoverGirl in the scent or flavour Sweet Tweet. It's got a teeny tiny bit left there. You can see it's just a reddish colour. It was very translucent, it didn't give you a lot of colour, but this became my either primer for what I would put on top, or I would use this before bed and in the morning I would just slap this on. So I do have another one which I don't like as much that I'm working through, but if you're in America and you want, because you can get CoverGirl in America but not over here really, and you want a lip balm, that one was a good one. I really like the flavour actually of that one. And finishing us up, we have a mascara. Focus, camera, focus. This is the Wake Me Up by Rimmel. I really didn't like this. I think there's quite a lot of product in here. In the end, I just kept avoiding it and I thought to myself, why am I keeping this? It's meant to be an extreme black mascara, and I want to say this might have been one of the ones that had like argan oil or something in it. I'm game for trying any new, what's my hair doing? Any new mascara really. So I picked this one up when it was on sale, when it first came in. It's not my favourite type of brush. It's massive and it is more of a bristle brush, when I do tend to prefer plastic ones. The brush was just way too big for my eye and I would just get it everywhere, and I found that it flaked on me quite a lot. It was just everything that I don't like in a mascara, so I definitely would not repurchase it. And actually, now thinking about it, there's not been that many Rimmel mascaras that I really have liked. And I'm not somebody that repurchases mascaras because there's always a new one coming. I tend to just buy the new ones out and try it. The only one I've ever repurchased is Maybelline The Rocket, because that one is really, really nice. But yeah, I wasn't a fan. So that was Empties. Let me know down below if you've tried any of these and had a good or bad experiences, and what you've been loving this month. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you soon. Bye guys.